Mass is that for the Feast of Our Lady of Perpetual Succour, which is today, with the commemoration of the vigil of St. Peter and Paul. The vigil is transferred from Sunday. It cannot be on a Sunday, so it's transferred to the preceding Saturday when it's on a Sunday. So it's commemoration of the vigil. The Mass of Our Lady of Perpetual Succour might be in the back of your missal in the, for the Mass of Perpetual Succour. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Ghost. Amen. The image of Our Lady of Perpetual Succour is the only icon we have in the Western Church. So icons are a special art form, a special form of painting, where it's not always proportional, it's not always realistic. There's exaggerations of some features, and other features are different. It's the art form of the East. Icon that the Western Church venerates is the icon of Our Lady of Perpetual Succour. It was most probably painted by St. Luke, who actually did know Our Lady, and so he was probably the one who painted it. And it's a very good image. It's a sad image. Our Lady is with our Lord, and they're sad, thinking about our Lord's suffering and how he's going to suffer so much for us. She's got the baby Jesus with her, and the angels Raphael and Gabriel are there in the picture as well, holding the images and holding the instruments of the Passion that our Lord is going to suffer from. It's been venerated for a long time. It was lost and found, and lost, and now miraculously is in the Church of the Redemptorists in Rome, and it's in front of the wall, but it's not fastened to the wall. It's just held there miraculously in front of the wall. Run chains behind it and strings behind it to see, yes, it's not fastened to the wall with any hooks or anything like this. It just floats in front of the wall in a miraculous manner. That's where Our Lady wanted the image to be, and she chose the spot where it would be placed and venerated now. So she was the one that decided that the Redemptorist would have guardianship of it, and the Redemptorists had a very efficacious novena to Our Lady of Perpetual Succour. They used to preach once a month their novena, and it was very effective novena. Father Cummins, who maybe some of you remember, was here. He used to preach that novena because he was a Redemptorist, and he would preach that novena every week. I think every Saturday he had that novena. Very loaded to Our Lady of Perpetual Succour. So succour, that's not a very common word in our language these days, but it means to take care of, and to nourish, and to provide for. This is what our Lady does for us, and this is what she does under this title. And so we should honor her under this title, and ask her to provide those things we need, and to ask her to help us, and ask her to help us especially to be sorry for our sins, and see what sufferings our Lord suffered for our sins, and how much Our Lady suffered for our sins, and how he knew he was going to suffer from the time he was infant for our sins, and that what the price of our sins cost, and how we should therefore say, well, I'm going to sin no more, looking at pile on more sins to the sufferings of our Lord, but I'm going to try to sin no more and to avoid my sins. And that's the best way we can honor Our Lady of Perpetual Succour. Saying, well, I'm not going to sorrow you anymore. I'm not going to make your heart sad anymore by my misbehavior, but rather I'm going to be good and always try to please you in all that I do. So ask Our Lady to pray for us today, and to relieve us of this persecution, this unbloody persecution we are suffering now from the hierarchy in the church especially, but also now from the world government that are persecuting us in such a manner that we're not at liberty to serve God as we would want to serve Him. We ask Our Lady to intercede for us and to protect us and to truly succor us in all of our needs. Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. Amen.